is currently working at Seabird's Medical Center, Hawaii. Today I'm going to talk on peripheral neuropathy. This is being a neuropathy awareness week, so I thought I'd have some few words about the same topic. So peripheral neuropathy, or the problem which is related to nerves, can occur at any age and to anyone. Broadly speaking, we have three different types of nerves. One is a motor nerve, other is a sensory nerve, and autonomic nerves. So patient will have symptoms according to the type of nerve fibers involved. If any patient who has involvement of motor nerves, they can have symptoms like weakness, either in the hands or legs, difficulty in balancing, difficulty in lifting objects. If they have a sensory neuropathy, the patient can have sensory symptoms which can be in the form of tingling, burning, numbness, or loss of sensation. If a patient has involvement of autonomic nerve fibers, they can have symptoms like difficulty in digestion, difficulty in sweating, erectile dysfunction, palpitations. Now, when a patient has similar symptoms, they should usually approach a neurologist. We usually approach this patient depending on the symptoms, and on clinical examination, we try to identify what is the cause of the neuropathy. In broad sense, about 40% of the cases, the cause is not known. However, the main causes which are encountered in our clinical practice include diabetes mellitus, leprosy, sarcoidosis, vasculitis. Certain neuropathies can be triggered because of toxins and medications, especially the cancer chemotherapy-related medications, or due to the nutritional deficiencies. Now, when the patient we examine the patient, depending how it has begun or how is the onset of the disease, depending on the clinical features, we ask for a set of investigations. The main idea is to identify the cause of the neuropathy and to treat the basic cause of the neuropathy. So, usually the investigations are targeted according to the that way. Routinely, investigating the diabetes and investigating the B12 levels help us to change the diagnosis and remove the patients. However, we might require certain blood investigations like vitamin D levels, sugar levels, ANA level, ANA profile, coming to urinary levels for the toxin assessment, serum toxic profile. In certain cases, we might require a nerve biopsy or a skin biopsy as well. Now, once we ascertain, yes, we do require nerve connection study also, so as to confirm our findings. Now, once the diagnosis of the neuropathy is confirmed, and once we have got the cause of the neuropathy, so we usually approach to the treatment. Treatment will depend upon the symptomatic control and the definite control of the core etiology. So, there are different class of medications which are available for the treatment of neuropathy. So, depending on the patient's profile, we start with the medications, and looking at the patient's response to the treatment, we monitor the medications. Once the patient is symptom-free, usually the medications are continued for 3 to 6 months. Once the patient is symptomatic for next 3 to 6 months, the medicines can be tapered depending on the clinical scenario. So, I would like to conclude that neuropathy is a disease of the nerves which has a different presentation and can occur because of different causes, and treatment of neuropathy is definitely possible. So, whenever you face such any problem, do consult your neurologist and help them in identifying the etiology by giving a proper history and detailed information. Thank you.